This game here is going to be an interesting one for the Grambling State Tigers. They're playing none other than the SWAC champions, Alabama A&M. Guys, I'm trying to tell you right now, the Bulldogs is looking to get out there and feast. So we're going to go ahead and break this thing down because I'm hearing that there's some changes that's going to take place within the Grambling State football lineup this week. So guys, y'all strap on in and get ready. It's your favorite coach back at it again. 10 toes down, about to tell you how it all went down. This is Tomorrow Leader Sports Network with your host, Coach Walker. If you're new to the channel, please like, share, subscribe, hit that notification bell to get all upcoming videos. And for all my leaders out there, welcome back. Y'all know the drill. Y'all know the routine. Hey, if you haven't done so already, make sure you hit that notification bell so you get all upcoming videos. Comment, like, share, and also tap in a friend or two. Tell them to come on in. It's nothing but positive vibes over here. We're just having a great time talking about HBCU sports. And not to mention, you can follow us on social media. The links are listed down below in the description. So without further ado, Coach going to go ahead and tap on in and get straight to the brass tacks of things so we can talk about this here game this weekend, what we can expect from both of these teams. Now, we already know that the quarterback carousel at Grambling State has been something that's just been going round and round, and they've been trying to figure out who fits best underneath center to lead the Tigers team to victory. Well, guess what? Coach Fobbs has decided he's going to make another change this week, in which he's going to start none other than freshman quarterback Noah Bodden. Now, I can understand why Coach Fobbs is looking to make this change, because the current quarterbacks that he's had in the game thus far has not produced in the manner in which the team has been looking for them to do so. But you know what? I'm going to be honest with you. Noah Bodden played high school football at Christ the King Regional in Middle Village, New York. He's a three-star recruit, ranked 10th in the state of New York, 122nd at the quarterback position, and 1,985 nationally. He's 6'4", 216-pound, right-handed quarterback with a quick release. We'll be seeing the SWAC champs come this Saturday. Four games Grambling State has played thus far. The quarterbacks that have been underneath center combined have thrown the ball 89 times, completing 39 for 327 yards, one touchdown, and three interceptions. Coach Fobbs making this change is not a bad idea for the Tigers because, you know what? The Bulldogs' defense have allowed opposing offenses to average 5.4 yards per carry running the ball, 7.9 yards per pass throwing the ball. Now, if Grambling can find a way to stay ahead of the chains and just run the ball, keeping that defense off the field, keeping the Bulldogs offense off the field, this may be a closer game than what many may think it will be. Now, Bodden would definitely need to count on his big uglies up front, making sure that they keep him clean back there in the pocket and allow him to get the plays off. So he's going to lean on number 63, Jordan Igafos, number 74, Kyle Davis, number 67, Chris Sharnick Jr., number 77, Tyler Thomas, number 61, Errol Walker. Like I said, trying to make sure they open up those holes for the running backs to run the ball as well as keeping him clean in the pocket, giving him time to throw the ball down the field to the Tigers receivers. Now, this week, the Bulldog defense, I'm going to be honest with you, I believe they're going to draw up some things to try and shake up the freshman quarterback, letting him know, hey, look, welcome to the SWAC. This ain't no easy way. You're going to have to earn your keep out here. And you know what? I really believe the Bulldogs defensive front, who I love to call the Trench Militia, number 43, Brandon Bailey, number 45, Trey Middleton, number 57, Phillip Hawkins, and number 92, Breon Austin, will look to confuse and throw a few wrinkles at Bodden, making sure that he's not able to get those passes off down the field to the Tigers receivers, or confusing him enough that he will throw interceptions to the other team or make costly mistakes throughout the game that will end up stalling some of their momentum when they're trying to move the ball down the field. Now, the Tigers defense will need to come up big this week against the Bulldogs offense because we already know Will Glass and the best receiver core in the SWAC, along with Mr. Gary Quarles, will put up 559 total offensive yards on a team at the drop of a nine. So with that being said, putting that type of pressure on any defense, that's like a 50-ton boulder that's on their shoulders trying to, you know, continue to keep moving down the field and staying engaged in the game to keep the Bulldogs from putting points on the board. You already know it's going to be fireworks. So I'm telling you now, Aquil Glass along with Gary Quarles and the best receiving core in the SWAC, number 2, Brian Juice Jenkins, 85, Ibrahim, 87, Howard, number 6, Hilaire, And number eight, Moore is looking to put in that work once again to show the opposing defense that your defensive scheme against them still ain't good enough. But you know what? I'm hoping Grambling comes out with a game plan to get after it this week, especially after the loss against Prairie View last week, in which they had the eviction notice held up after the game, said that this was for Grambling State Tigers for the State Fair Classic. Now, I don't know about you, but that would light a fire up underneath my behind, wanting to get out there and make sure that that does not happen to me nor my team again. My score prediction, unfortunately, this week, I'm going with Alabama A&M. In this one, I have them 27-10. But until next time, guys, if you like the content, please like, share, subscribe, hit that notification bell, comment, and share these videos. Also, you can follow us on social media. The links are listed down below in the description. And remember, guys, be the one and lead.